stocks ended the day mixed after a strong start, but Bitcoin is the belle of the ball today. The price surged to an all-time high of more than $50,000. And this new record comes as more major companies are backing it. Thank you for joining us tonight at 7:30. I'm Megan Schiller. The world's largest digital currency rose to more than 3% this morning. It comes as large firms like Tesla and MasterCard are showing support. Tesla bought $1.5 billion worth of Bitcoin last week, and the company says it plans to accept the digital coin as payment for its cars. Joining me now live over Zoom is Chief Investment Officer with Fragasso Advisors, Michael Godwin. Michael, thank you for joining us tonight.
Thanks, Megan.
So first off, can you explain to us what is Bitcoin?
So Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency, meaning that it is a digital alternative to the money that we use today. I think two of the biggest differences between Bitcoin and the dollar are, one, Bitcoin is decentralized, meaning no one person, no bank, no government controls it. And secondly, there is a finite supply of Bitcoin available. And I bring that up because I'm sure that most viewers remember that our dollars used to be backed by gold. But in the early 1970s, we broke away from that standard. And essentially, governments now have the ability to print as much money as they see fit, and which we've obviously become accustomed to over the past years as governments try to stimulate their economies given the COVID-19 pandemic. So the fact that there's a finite number of Bitcoin available is one of the reasons that bullish investors point to regarding the cryptocurrency.
What are people using Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies for right now? What are they buying?
Not much, Megan. That's one of the interesting components of Bitcoin. You can go out and purchase a few things, but most investors are hoarding it, hoping that the price continues to rise. For Bitcoin to really have a true amount of value going forward, it needs to become a source of payment over the long haul. I think that's what Tesla and MasterCard and PayPal are sort of betting on or don't want to miss out on, is that over the next 10 to 20 years or so, Bitcoin may become a very viable currency in the digital world.
In your opinion, is this another GameStop situation where people should be doing their research and jumping in to invest?
That's a good question. I think over the past 5 months, the cryptocurrency, in particular Bitcoin and some other ones like Ethereum, have gone pretty parabolic without much reason to go as high as they've gone. Bitcoin is up 5x over the past 4 months alone. So I do think that there's a lot of embedded volatility into it. And if I had to guess, I think there'd be a better opportunity to jump in if you wanted to invest in Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies.
And if we're not sure exactly how this is going to go, why are major companies warming up to the idea of Bitcoin now?
I think a lot of companies want to have the option to allow payments of Bitcoin over their medium. So PayPal and MasterCard and Bank of New York Mellon being those. And Tesla has generally been at the forefront with some of these things in the past. So it's more of a bet on, I don't want to miss out on this if it's going to become a very big component of the currency or the digital currency world in 10 to 20 or 30 years or so.
And for people who aren't paying attention to the digital currency world, is this surge different than past rallies, and why are we seeing this surge?
Well, keep in mind that Bitcoin has only been around since 2009. So there's not a lot of history with the price of Bitcoin. I mean, who's to tell you? It's really hard to value what one Bitcoin should be worth. In 2018, Bitcoin lost 80% of its value over the course of the year. So I think that there's obviously a lot of embedded volatility in it. But if you're not a very risk-averse investor, I think certain types of cryptocurrencies could work out in your portfolio. But as I mentioned before, it's a very speculative asset, and I venture to believe that there will likely be a better entry point than where we're at today.
Michael, thank you.
Thanks for having me.